Very good afternoon to one and all. I'm Dr. Tanuja. I'm a resident doctor of Partha Dental. And we are here going live for a Facebook event that we are doing for just an awareness during our Partha Dental, what we are doing for a promotion. It is, before I start off, this is a live web chat. You are free to ask me any questions regarding the dental problems or anything about the treatment protocols, where our clinics are. So talking about the different dental treatments, I would like to start off with a little bit about our clinics. So our clinics started off first by our esteemed CMD, Dr. P.V. Parthasarathy, sir, who first started off his humble beginnings in Tirupati. So it was just one set of clinic, and then he came to know that, you know, all these modern technologies and facilities, he wanted to make it more available to the common man. So as he went further, he also started expanding few of the clinics. And I'm really proud to say that we are one of the largest networks right down in South India at this moment. So you can ask us, how are we unique from other clinics? So here, if you just walk into any one of our clinics, you can see that we have the state-of-the-art modern facilities with recent advancements. You can see lasers, you can see OPGs, intraoral cameras, and these all helps us as a team to assess and diagnose your problems. We are around right now 84 plus branches with 1,000 employees and 250 plus doctors, that is specialists, who will render to all your needs. So it is more of a team effort than a single doctor, you know, diagnosing your problems. So right now we are on live chat again. Coming to the introduction, my name is Dr. Tanuja. I've done my post-graduation in maxillofacial radiology and also a fellowship in medical cosmetology. And I've been a part of a resident doctor here in Partha Dental. So all your questions can be made live right now, and I will answer a few of your questions. I can see a lot of questions coming up already. So Mr. Indraneel already started off with the question. Can you tell about invisible braces? Okay. Thank you for this question, Mr. Indraneel. Invisible braces, first of all, let me just tell you what braces are. Braces are is a part of a branch, specialized branch called orthodontics, in which suppose if you feel that your teeth are forwardly placed, or it is malaligned, or it is disorderly arrangement, due to various of reasons, we can go for something called as an orthodontic treatment. In this orthodontic treatment, we have various modes of treatment, which is like the which is like the metal braces. We have the ceramic braces, and then you can also go for the invisible braces. So here, Mr. Indraneel, you are asking for what is an invisible braces is nothing but braces. If you are part of like a, you don't want that braces to be seen. For example, it's something like this. So these are the ones where you can just walk into one of our clinics. So we'll take an impression of your oral cavity. We'll see the x-rays, and we'll just order this. It's a prefabricated braces. And the advantage of these braces over your normal metal braces, I can show you a picture where this normal metal braces and the ceramic braces are there. These are the ones which are the metal braces. I think it's visible right now. Yeah. So these are the metal braces which is there on your tooth. So as you can see, these metal braces don't look very much appealing compared to, these ceramic ones. So these are much, it is an advanced treatment, but still it is also, it causes less problems such as ulcerations, and you are more It is more, what can you say? It is more accessible to you. You can just go and, if you want to go for a meeting and you don't want anybody to see that you have something on your teeth. So it is basically a piece. So invisible braces comes in something like this. You just need to place it and it's not seen at all. So definitely you can opt for it. Are specialist doctor available in your hospital? Yes, Mr. Indrani. All specialist doctors are available. As you know, I hope you know, there are around 7 branches available in dentistry as such. And all the specialist doctors are available in our clinic 24/7. And if you want to book any particular appointment with anybody, you can call our toll-free number, which is 1-800-002-8686. So questions are just keeping on coming. So I'm just going to... okay, so Mr. Babalu is asking a question. Are teeth implants really painless while chewing meat? Mr. Babalu, there is no problem. Teeth implants they do not cause any pain. Tooth implants, as you can see, is nothing but suppose you have a problem of a missing teeth and you want to get it replaced. The most advanced treatment of this is a tooth implant. So a tooth implant, I can show you, is it is an inert material. It's a material which is just put inside your teeth, and it is it's biocompatible. It does not cause any harm to your body, and it can be done in a day. You can just come in. You have a missing tooth due to any various reasons. Let it be, during an accident, you fell off, the tooth is not there, but immediately you want a replacement. So it is just immediately inside your bone. See, this is a picture of the tooth implant. It will be placed inside your bone. And we can replace a missing teeth, or a prosthesis can be immediately placed on the single day itself. This can be done in a week. So we have everybody available here. You just need to walk in and you can just go for these implants. They are quite painless. We cannot say painful and painless as such. But yes, it will be not causing you any sort of discomfort. Is there any treatment, Mr. Manu Manya? Hello. Hi. So is there any treatment to correct my teeth without coming every month to the doctor? Yes, that's what I told. Mr. Indri has a question a few minutes back. That's the same thing. You can go for the invisible braces. The invisible braces, as you can see. So here, these are prefabricated braces which will come to you. You need not come to us for every month for a treatment. But these are the best options you can go for. Mr. Indranil, how to book an online appointment? Yes, here you can see that you can just simply, it's as simple, you can just log into our website, which is www.parthadental.com, or you can just call the toll-free number, which is 1-800-102-8686. So it is as easy as that. You can just go to the website, book an appointment, and we will be in with you. You can go to the nearest branches that are available. Again, we have over 84 plus branches right now running all over in Hyderabad, Telangana, and also right down in Bangalore. So these things, you can just book an appointment to your convenience and need. Okay, so since all questions are still coming up, we can go for certain my topic for today, which I would really like to discuss with everyone. So Partha Dental stands for, the motto of this entire show is awareness and accessibility and affordability. We stand by the 3 golden rules. So it is just to make everybody, the public, aware of all the dental problems and dental treatments that are available, and accessibility, to make you understand where all our clinics are also there, and also affordability. Are all these treatments really affordable? Yes. So all those questions I can be answered. So moving into the topic of today, I want to discuss on the diagnosis part. The diagnosis part, when you come into the clinic, how important it is to diagnose what kind of dental problems you are dealing with. So the first major problem is why should you go to a dental clinic? This is the first question which everybody asks. Is it necessary that we should go once in a while to a dental clinic? How often should we go to a dental clinic? You can visit your dental clinic, which is nearby, just for a regular checkup. So your oral health is actually a mirror of your general health. So if any problem occurs with your general health, it's the signs and indications come in your oral cavity as well. So if you go to a dentist, they can probably diagnose if there is any problem. And actually, these are the first signs and symptoms which may also help you to recognize certain general health problems which you may have. So you can ask, what are the common problems that we usually encounter in our dental practice? So the normal problems that we usually see is, suppose there's bleeding gums. So the bleeding gums, you may also have abnormal bleeding gums if you are a hypertensive. Or hypertensive is nothing but high blood pressure. So so bleeding gums is nothing but, as you can see here, I can show you a picture. See, this is where, when suppose you brush your teeth and there is abnormal bleeding in your gum. And if you're hypertensive, it will be more. So what can you do about this? What can you do if you have bleeding gums? It's nothing, it's as simple as that. You can come to the clinic, you can just tell your doctor that there is, you know, doctor, I am having bleeding while brushing my teeth. So the doctor will definitely diagnose whether you have any dirt in the teeth, or whether this bleeding is occurring due to any other problem or any other general health conditions that you're having. And once it's done, the doctor will definitely recommend you for a cleaning process, or a scale, which is also called as a scaling process. So I can show you that the cleaning before and after if you do a cleaning. A cleaning is nothing but they use an ultrasonic scalar set and they use to clean inside your gums. The dirt will remove. And see, you can see this is done in one of our clinics. See, this is the tooth which is having a lot of calculus. Calculus is nothing but the dirt which will mix up with the saliva, all your food particles which mix up with saliva, and there will be a lot of organisms on that. And then this, they'll ask them to do a cleaning. So once it's done, so you can see once it's cleaned, the tooth looks much better. You have a better oral hygiene. The breath smells much better. You feel much better, and the oral health is definitely much higher than the what you have walked into our clinic for. Okay. Hi, Sarah. Thank you for coming online, and thank you for asking me this question. Hi, doctor. Can you please tell me about recession of gums and the cause for it? Yes. Recession of gums occurs if your brushing technique is not proper, or you are having any sort of gum disease. So what happens is, recession means your gum level comes down. So your gum, whatever the gum level has to be on the normal part, it just goes off a little down, and your tooth root starts being exposed. And once it's exposed, the tooth becomes mobile or it starts shaking. So again, for this treatment, you can see a gum specialist is always available in our clinics, and you can just walk in, and once they know that you, what exactly is the problem, even diabetes or sugar can be a cause for a gum recession or mobility of your teeth. So again, this needs gum therapy. We will take an x-ray, we will assess your bone height, we will assess your gum height, and then after the x-ray is taken, you will need a gum rejuvenation, or a gum therapy will be done, which will further prevent it from going down again. So so you can just meet one of our specialists, Sarah, and that can be done. A person with missing teeth, can they go for braces treatment? Yes, they can go for braces treatment. Depends on how many teeth is missing. If all the teeth are missing, we cannot do a braces treatment, definitely. But depends on the number of tooth that are missing, whether an implant should be placed in that area, or whether they would like, on the bone level also. Depends on what is the reason the tooth is missing. So it can be due to any syndromes, or it can be associated to general health of the patient. So again, we have to diagnose and see, and then we will recommend the person is eligible for an ortho treatment, but definitely they can. So the next question is from Mr. Midun. I have a TMJ problem and I can't open my mouth beyond a particular limit. Yes, TMJ, for those of you who don't know what is a TMJ, TMJ in full form is called a temporomandibular joint. That's a joint which is just in front of your ears and it helps you to open your mouth and close your mouth. This also helps you for the side to side movements, which is left and lateral, and it also helps you in chewing. And this joint is also attached to a lot of muscles. So if you have a TMJ problem, you have to be a little more specific, Mr. Midun. Is it, do you have a clicking sound or is it problem in opening the mouth? So if you're not able to open your mouth beyond a particular point, then definitely you can just come have a diagnosis as to why that pain is occurring, or is it due to the problem with any of your tooth occlusion, whether the biting problem, or whether they are not in the correct position. So we have to see whether that is causing a problem to your TMJ, or the TMJ problem is coming from a muscular problem. Okay. Because even TMJ problem can occur if your muscles are having any, you know, if there's any facial pain or trigger points on the muscles. These all can be done once we diagnose the problem. And once the diagnosis of the problem is related, then we can assess what treatment plan should be followed for your TMJ disorder. So I think questions are, you know, gonna come. So before that, as we were talking, so we were talking about the gum diseases before. So gum diseases, there is a lot of things that we have covered, like the calculus, the recession, and the bone level. So all these can be diagnosed once you enter, once we take a full x-ray of your oral cavity, and once we see that what is the bone level, what is the height, and the proper treatment can be rendered to your needs. So the next one, the most common problem that we can see is cavities. I bet everybody out there who is facing a dental problem can always associate with cavities, or which is called as decay of your teeth. So the normally the decay of the teeth can be a discoloration. Usually people see a slight discoloration of the tooth and they want to go to a dentist, or the discoloration moves further deep inside and then it becomes a little more big cavity where your food gets lodged in, and this becomes a problem while you chew your food and then you go and see a doctor. So this is a case where you can see that the person is having a decay in his front tooth. So what are the treatments when you have a decay in your tooth? If it's a normal decay which is in the upper level of your tooth, we'll definitely ask you to go for a simple filling. But if it has gone for beyond a point, then we will ask you to do something called as a root canal therapy. So root canal therapy is nothing but we will place an inert material inside your tooth. We will shape the tooth into the root canal specialist will shape the tooth and then put this inert material inside the tooth, and then they'll ask you to go for a cap. So root canal therapy is one of the major treatments that happens if you do not, if you're not able to, find out if you're having pain or you have pain during the night, and and it is not on the initial stages. So definitely a root canal therapy is what we would recommend. Okay, so there's another question. Tell us about the teeth grinding habit and how it affects the TMJ. So thank you for this question. So again, it comes back to the temporomandibular joint, where the temporomandibular joint is right again in front of your ear. So if you are having a grinding habit, which is during your sleep and you will not be aware of it, it always affects your TMJ because of the constant stress. So here I have with me, it's like a TMJ has a pain cycle. So what happens is when you keep on grinding your tooth abnormally while you're in sleep, so what happens is it causes a constant stress on that particular joint. And once that joint is having that particular stress, it undergoes this constrictive blood supply to that particular region. So the blood supply, when it is less, there are chemical changes which occurs inside the muscles. So this particular cycle, when it keeps on continuing and it keeps on going around, the patient after a period of 6 months, or when you experience it for a period of 6 months and beyond, this becomes chronic. And this is when you will have experience of difficulty in opening your mouth, or there will be difficulty in chewing. So again, this treatment, you have to come to us. Again, we have to diagnose whether this is occurring due to the muscles, whether it has affected the muscles, and then we will tell you the correct treatment protocol to be followed. There will be a series of exercises which you have to do in the clinic, or you have to do at home. An appliance will definitely be given to you, which you have to wear. And then a constant and periodic follow-up is also being done. So definitely, thank you for this question. So grinding and teeth habit, definitely come to us. We will give you the correct treatments for it. Okay. So coming on to the next diseases that we can diagnose is, I have covered on the cavities and gum diseases. So what is the other most common diseases that people have? One is called as the wisdom tooth. So the wisdom tooth, how does it cause pain? Usually a wisdom tooth is nothing but the last part of the last teeth that has to come out. So the wisdom tooth is comes on your last lower or right, left, upper, the last part of your teeth. So even the wisdom tooth, when it's trying to come out, there are some patients who will experience a lot of pain while it comes out. So a wisdom tooth, how you may have a swelling in that region, you may experience some sort of soreness when you're trying to open your mouth, and it pains while chewing. So all these things, and patients do come to us complaining of pain in the extreme end of their tooth region. So a wisdom tooth may or may not come for a lot of people. Those people, when it does not come after a particular age, we use the term as impacted teeth. An impacted teeth means that the wisdom tooth is inside the bone. So I can show you a picture here. So here I have wisdom tooth, and it is inside the bone. The teeth is actually inside the bone right here, and it is unable to come out. It can not come out due to a various of reasons, because it can be because of the less space, and it is unable to come to the particular position. So definitely we will ask you for a wisdom tooth removal. And we have specialists here who will help you with that as well. And the procedure is pretty simple. It's nothing to be scared of. It is just a little bit trimming of your bone and just removing that tooth, which can be done under 40 minutes. So wisdom tooth is also one of the most common problems that most of the patients walk in with. Then the next question is, ma'am, help me, left side jaw pain because I have right side RCT. So I always chew food from the left side. Tell me a solution. So I would have to certainly diagnose you for that problem, because if you're having a left side joint pain, bone pain, because of a right side RCT, definitely there should be a problem on your left side. Or it can be a problem arising due to your TMJ. So we'll have to diagnose you on that side. So your right side RCT will never cause a problem on your left side, because all your nerves that are applied on your right side is different and your left side is different. So the next question is, my father is a diabetic and needs to go for an implant. I hear different options. What would you say he can go for, doctor? So thank you for this question, Mr. Roy. Roy, I would just say that a diabetic does not mean that you cannot place an implant. If he's a controlled diabetic, definitely an implant is the best option you can go for. Nowadays, it can be done in a day. The processes or the crown or the tooth replacement can be done in a day. So a diabetic patient is definitely a suitable patient, or the appropriate patient, if he's under control. If it's a controlled diabetic, he definitely can go for the implants. So it's not a problem at all. So as the questions keep coming, I can move on to the next part of the topic. We were talking about the wisdom tooth removal. Another common thing that people usually complain as they come into the clinic is the missing teeth. So right now we were discussing on whether implants and other treatment modalities. A missing teeth can occur due to various reasons. It can be maybe due to an accident, you might have lost the missing tooth, or it can be due to any other reasons that it may have not come out, or you may have lost the teeth during due to a dental caries. So a missing teeth, how can you replace a missing tooth? So these days, as I was just discussing previously as before, missing tooth can definitely be replaced by using, nowadays people prefer, or what we prefer to go ahead with, is an implant. An implant, as I told, is the best modality for missing teeth. And we have other replacements such as called as the removal partial denture, which is nothing but you can replace a missing teeth, but it is not a fixed solution. So definitely an implant is what we would recommend if there is a missing teeth. Do you have Botox treatment in your hospital? Definitely, yes. We have Botox treatment as well. Depends on what kind of treatment you want to render onto your facial structure. For Botox, you would like to, have your fine lines removed. Botox can be definitely done. It is a simple procedure again. Botulinum is nothing but a solution which will be injected into your fine lines, and the fine lines will be removed with this solution. So, is advanced PPS denture treatment? So, I think there's a lot of doubt on what all treatments we have in our hospital. Let me again confirm this. Our hospital can do any sort of treatment which is in the advanced dentistry, because all our clinics are equipped, very, very equipped, let me tell you that. And we have a mix of technology, and it is readily available to the common man. So definitely all those treatments which you feel, if you feel that, is it available? Yes, all the treatments are available, and we are here to definitely serve you. We work as a team. As I told you, we have 250 plus specialist doctors, and any of these doctors are all the time 24/7 ready to help you out. So all the treatments are available. So yes, my answer to all the question of whether any treatment is available in the hospital, yes, I'm definite and proud to say that it is. That's it. I think few questions are to come. So I can just continue with my topic again. So topics, the next one is the wisdom tooth. Well, the other thing that we commonly and normally face is the missing teeth, the cavities, and the bleeding gum. These are the most common things that people come here for us. And all these treatments, as I told you, it can start off with just the bleeding gums. We can do a normal cleaning, which will immediately show an effect in your oral cavity. A missing tooth, an implant, definitely. We have the best implantologists. We have the best surgeons. We have the best processes that we can give you. So definitely a missing teeth can be solved. And you're also, we were talking on the forward placement of the teeth or the orthodontic corrections. So these are the common problems which we come from. And so the missing teeth, if your entire oral cavity does not have teeth, will definitely right now we are in line to do with implants. You can go for a full mouth implants as well, or fixed implants, where we will be placing implants in your oral cavity. And if depending on your bone height and bone level, we will also assess. But first, you have to come to our clinics, or any of the clinics. We have to take an X-ray. This is the basic procedure that we follow to see that what is the bone health, what is your bone height, and then go for a proper prosthesis. So what we can talk about is this. About the ortho treatment, when we were talking on, is there any correct age for ortho treatment? You can start off your ortho treatment at the age of 12 years, but definitely preventive treatment for your child is also done. We have a child specialist, which is known as a periodontist, will definitely see your child's teeth, the alignment, and then recommend whether something should be done before the age of 12 years. So that orthodontic treatment is nothing but called as an interceptive, or it can be, it is a child orthodontics, which can also be done. Can an adult do about 30 to 35 years? Adult orthodontics is also made available. We have a few cases which are done in our clinic, and a smile is definitely a curve that sets everything straight. So a smile will definitely increase your confidence level. It increases your face value. So an orthodontic treatment is something which would definitely be in favor of you if your tooth is malaligned, it is forwardly placed, and you do not feel good about how you smile. An ortho treatment is definitely what we recommend. Let me just show you a few cases that we have done in ortho here, so you will get an idea as to what we do. So orthodontic treatment can also be done in cases of whether your, not only your malalignment and also the forward placement, there can also be a spacing between your teeth. So these spacing, all these things can be closed with a simple orthodontic correction. So this is a case right here where, I hope you can see it. Yeah, the teeth is inclined and the teeth is disorderly arranged. Yes, here. So it is not arranged, it is little inclined, and after the ortho treatment, it is back in correction again. So this is a case of, again, spacing, and you can see there is spacing in the teeth. You can see spacing in the teeth, right? So this particular patient came to us, and after a particular ortho treatment, she's got a beautiful smile. See? So definitely, we are here to help you. We are here to increase your confidence level, and definitely an ortho treatment can increase your smile value. So that's what orthodontics is all about. So next is so you can also ask me as to what happens if you don't correct, or you don't go for an ortho treatment in cases where there is a malalignment or where there are disorderly arranged teeth. So this can cause other problems, such as when your bite, if your bite is not problem, if your bite is not proper, what happens is that the occlusion is nothing but your bite, what I'm talking about. If it is not proper, it will have problems while you are chewing. The constant stress, as we talked a few minutes back about the temporomandibular disorders or the joint pains that can occur in chronic conditions of over 6 months, all these pains will occur. You will not have a proper session to bite your teeth or grind. So all these things may cause a problem while you chew. So orthodontic treatment should definitely be done if it is also to have a good smile. So the next thing that we can talk about is, so there's any questions, I can just answer a few of your questions. Okay. So there's no questions coming in as of now. So you're free to call in our toll-free numbers again, 1-800-102-8686, or simply log into parthadental.com and book an appointment with any of the branches that are nearby to you. And once you do this, please walk into any one of our clinics, get a proper diagnosis and a treatment plan. You're also free to just come and just see the clinic, how it functions and what are the techniques and the treatments that are available here. Again, we have 250 plus specialists all over with 1,000 plus employees. So you can just walk in and get to know us and get to know what treatment we are here, always here to help you. We are always in your service. So the next thing I can talk on is of there is something called as the certain lesions that occur inside your oral cavity. This is something thing which many people are a little unaware of. So lesions that are occurring in your oral cavity can be due to many various reasons. It can be also you may be a chronic smoker, a tobacco user. So you will be either smoking for a period of more than 10 plus years, or you will be also you chewing a lot of tobacco. So all these conditions, especially tobacco, will have something called as ericolin, which goes into your oral cavity and causes various changes inside your oral cavity. So what is the problem of using excessive tobacco or excessive form of smoking? It is nothing but that it causes a lot of changes inside your oral cavity. So ericolin and tobacco, the small changes is nothing but it is a precancerous condition of what is happening inside, and it is nothing but a sign. So here with me, I have, suppose if you are a chronic tobacco user, there is a condition known as oral submucosa fibrosis, in which what happens is inside your oral cavity, you can see here, this is a case that had come to a clinic. So I'll just show it to you. So there is light changes in the oral cavity where you can see fibrous bands that are running straight across. So what happens is, during the time of an excessive tobacco chewing, and the ericolin gets deposited inside the oral cavity, makes it fibrous. And is there a particular treatment for it? There is no exact cure for it, but there is definite treatment. So when you come to our clinic, we start off you with some steroids therapy. We will help you to help in cessation of the tobacco habit. And also all these your diet modifications will also be done. So you can just walk in, as I said, and this oral submucosa fibrosis can definitely be under controlled, or it cannot be fully reversed, but yet slight changes can occur. And we can definitely, there are cases which go where you are unable to open your mouth. So those cases, definitely we have done a lot of treatments in our clinic, and this is one of the cases. And we can start off with steroid therapy, and after the steroid therapy are done, definitely you can see a marginal improvement or from what you have walked in. So the next thing is commonly is the ulcers also. So there will be many of you who will experience certain form of ulcers. It can be small ulcers, it can be a large ulcers. Ulcers are nothing but, as you can see here, they are, this is a major ulcer. So it is nothing, it is erosive. It can be inside your tongue, it can be inside your oral cavity. So it causes a lot of discomfort. So this is also one of the most common problems that patients usually come off with. So there are that the ulcers can also be definitely treated. We can put you on a certain oils and gels. So once it's and we can keep an observation. Certain ulcers definitely need more observation if it is not healing, because it can be leading into form of any form of cancer, or it can be, what I'm trying to tell you is that if it is diagnosed at an earlier stage, certain ulcers can be watched for. So periodic follow-up is definitely recommended in such cases. So again, please call in our toll-free numbers, which is 1-800-102-8666, and the toll-free numbers are there for you to just call if you want to book an appointment with us, and log into www.parthadental.com. Then some the next thing that you can come in for us, we were talking about the various gum diseases. So the gum, other than gum diseases, you can also ask, can a cleaning actually whiten my tooth? So whitening of tooth and cleaning is two different processes. Cleaning of tooth just removes your dirt inside your oral cavity. Definitely, what is the dirt or the calculus or the tartar that is there? Whitening of tooth is done by a process called as a bleaching. So a bleaching is a cosmetic part of the dentistry treatment, where the bleaching is you want your teeth to look whiter, in a different shade, a better shade than what is there. So bleaching can be done in house within 40 minutes once you enter and walk into a clinic. So once doctor sees you, they will see what kind of shade of color of your teeth. Are all the patients recommended for bleaching? Again, as we see you, we diagnose you. You're definitely, if it is a treatment that can be rendered, we will be providing you with that treatment. So you can see. So in 40 minutes, we'll be doing bleaching process on your teeth. So you can definitely see that there will be. This is one of our cases done in a clinic. You can see that the tooth color is. This is how the patient came with the tooth color, and after the bleaching process of 40 minutes, 40 to 45 minutes, the definite shade improvement is there. So definitely you have a healthy smile and you have a better smile, and a whiter smile definitely increases your confidence level. And is bleaching recommended to be done by yourself at home? There are many patients there are many bleaching kits that are available online. No, definitely I will not recommend you to bleaching process by yourself, and so I would definitely recommend request you to go visit your dentist if you want a bleaching to be done on your teeth. Please do not do it at home. Please do not do it by yourself. It is certainly the percentage that you use in certain solutions are not recommended. So please go to your dentist if you need a proper bleaching and a healthy smile. So that is all about the bleaching process and the bleaching technique. Kindly, this is a live show. You can ask me any form of dental question or things that you want to know about, any dental awareness. So this is mainly our motto is awareness, affordability, accessibility. So you can ask me, doctor, all the treatments, what you are saying is quite expensive. Yes, they are a little bit expensive, but our main aim is to make it affordable to you, right? So how is this affordable? We have the two pillars, which is unique in all our clinics compared to all the other clinics. So we have, suppose if your treatment is quite expensive and you feel it is not affordable, the two pillars that follows is the capital float and the bajaj. So there, you can just come in and you want us to start off any of your treatments. We can just start it off that day there without you paying us a single rupee on that day, where your bajaj and capital float will come and they will help you with the processes. So there is a 0% interest as well. So you need not worry about whether the treatments are affordable. So our duty is to provide the services to you. So the affordability. So this is where I talk about the affordability part. And accessibility, always you can log into our website. And awareness, please ask me any question. I'm here to answer any of your dental questions. And this is the whole motive of this live chat show. And for those who have been with us just today, just for your just for the information's sake, what I can tell you is we started the show 2 weeks back. We have all the specialists which comes, and they come every day from 2 to 4. So they are here to answer any of your various dental questions. So you can be free, ask us any questions. Is there any recommendations? What can be done? What is the what are the different types of treatments that are available? How it is affordable? Can I walk into any of these questions can be readily answered. So the next thing that I would like to talk on is so we've covered the wisdom tooth, we have covered missing teeth, and there is something called as this is not a diagnosis of a particular problem. We also have this small thing called as a tooth jewelry. So you can go ahead, and if you feel like you want to enhance your smile and you want to look a little unique than the other people around, you can definitely go for something called the tooth jewelry that is here, right here, that you can see. So we have it in all different forms of shade. It is like a topaz color. There is a blue color. There is green color. There's a lot of different colors that are available in tooth jewelry. So this is something which is also available in our clinic. And they also come in. These are the different. I hope you can see it here. Yeah. So the different colors that are there, you can go for different tooth jewelry. It also makes you feel unique. So questions, so no questions so far. So I can go ahead and talk a little bit on the topic about there are many of you patients out there who might be suffering from facial pain. So facial pain is, in our terms, we say it as myofacial pain, which occurs in your facial area. So myofacial pain can occur to any person of any age. This can be also due to your improper arrangement of the teeth can be one reason, or due to your chronic stress can be another reason. So all this different etiological factors or different factors can cause a pain in your facial area. So as you can see, what happens in myofacial pain or a pain in your pain in your facial area is the patients become chronically depressed. So they do not know why the pain is occurring. So this can on long term, there are some patients which suffer from a severe intensity of pain in a unilateral region, which is termed as a trigeminal neuralgia. So it can be a neuralgic pain, it can be a facial pain. So under diagnosis, this all these pains here, as you can see they may also experience, see, this is a facial pain which is radiating to your head region. It is radiating down tooth oral cavity, and even a slight problem in your wisdom tooth can cause a facial pain. So definitely do walk into any one of our clinics. We'll be able to diagnose as to what is causing that facial pain. It is, do you know that even facial pain can cause problems for your neck region? Yes, it's true. So it can cause problems in your neck region, and it can radiate down. It can radiate down to your shoulder regions. So what are the treatments available here is that if you walk in, if you have a facial pain, you can come to us and we can start treatments. There are particular exercises and also certain appliances that we will give you and certain procedures to be done so that your facial pain is reduced. We are here to always serve you. So do walk in. So facial pain is one of a major concern these days to a lot of patients. So please do ask any questions. I am here to answer. I'm here always available to answer any of your questions. So if it is a dental problem, a dental concern, what should be done? What should not be done? So please do ask those any type of questions that are there. So what kind of toothpaste would you recommend? Yes. Toothpaste, anything that is white in color, other than, I do not recommend the gel form, but anything that is white in color and has less abrasives, I would definitely recommend with that. For a child, patient, definitely more fluoride content is more advisable. So any form of toothpaste that is white in color with less abrasives, a little more fluoride content, I would recommend that toothpaste. So if there are no questions, I can talk a little bit about on particular topics, which anything that you want to ask on, please do ask. So this is a chat show that is live, and you can ask any questions. You can again go back to our toll-free number 1-800-102-8686. We are a branch of Clinics 84 Plus that is available all over. And this was right now, it is headed by a lot of specialists, and there is a lot of branches available all over Hyderabad, Telangana, and also right down in Bangalore. So you can take up any of our appointments. So let us, any questions, please do ask. And talking about ortho treatment, we can also talk on what different type of things that we can do on the teeth. So if we are a person who wants the treatment to be faster and you do not want to wait for a longer duration, then you can go for something called as a smile designing. So what is smile designing? Smile designing is nothing but when you walk in and we see that your tooth is forwardly placed. So, and you don't know, and it is such a position that you want the treatment to be done further. So it is done. So what we can do is, what I would recommend definitely is a smile designing, where we can assess your teeth, and the doctor, so that specialist of smile designing will come, will assess your teeth, will try to design your teeth in such a way that, you know, the teeth is in correct position and you have a better smile. So this is purely a cosmetic part. So for those who wants a faster treatment, and you can go and opt for a smile designing. Here with me, I have a few cases of smile designing where I can show you. So smile designing is usually done with treatment with crowns, and crowns are usually recommended if, excuse me, until I take a picture. So you can see here, that there is his teeth. There is this particular patient who came to us. So you can see that his teeth was disorderly arranged, and he wanted the treatment very immediately. So what we did was a smile designing. You can see the after effects. This is a before. We placed crowns on it. So that is where the smile designing comes into place. So if not an ortho, you can definitely go for a smile designing. Again, walk into one of our clinics. We'll be here. We'll diagnose you, and we will tell you what smile designing is available, what kind, how it will look before, how it will look after. So please ask any questions. I'm here to answer any of your questions. Coming on to something related to the diagnosing of different diseases, as I have told a few minutes, the most common are your gum diseases, where your gum starts bleeding. There's a lot of bone level coming down. Yes, you can. We have treatments for that. Then there is cavities. Then there is that dental decay. So anything that is causing you a problem in your oral cavity, it starts off right when you walk into any of our clinics. We'll diagnose it. We'll tell you what exactly is the problem. It's not really what problem you come up with. We will also diagnose different other problems as well. So you are again free to ask me. This is a live web show. So you can go ahead, ask me any of the questions. So this show has been occurring from past 2 weeks. So we are all group of specialist doctors. We are residents here. We are here to answer any of your questions from 2 to 4 p.m. Then anything related to your gums we can discuss right now is about another question which can come is the discoloration of your teeth. So if there is discoloration of your gums. So when there is discoloration of your gums, this is how it looks. There can be people who will have discolored gums right now. So once the gums are discolored, what is the other treatment that you can go for is this called as a gum depigmentation, where we use lasers and we reduce the pigmentation on your gums. This can also be done, yes. So you can see right here, so the gum was completely discolored before, right over here, and then after doing a laser treatment, it is completely colored again. So this is called as the gum depigmentation, which will be done in any one of our clinics. So definitely this increases your smile. It increases the healthier condition of your teeth. Looks much, much better. So yes, so this can also be done. So as we were discussing on trigeminal neuralgia or any neurological pain. So what is happening is in neuralgia, your main nerve, your trigeminal nerve, which is inside, it just gets affected. So the patients will, let me just enlarge it for you. Yeah, there. So the patients will get this severe intensity of pain on the lateral side of your face. So this pain can be very excruciating, and most of the patients will find it very difficult to do their day-to-day activities. So what happens in such cases is that patients usually do not even go for their work, do not even do their day-to-day activities. So how can we treat it? Yes, we can start off by just diagnosing which part of the nerve is causing you the problem, and what certain medications can also be done. A constant follow-up is always a protocol in any one of our clinics. So definitely we will be following up on each sessions, and I can guarantee you that starting as you start the treatment from here till the end of all our sessions, you will find a lot of drastic change in cases of trigeminal neuralgic patients. So so this is also related to your facial pain and your facial ulcer, facial pain and chronic pain that the patients usually have. So the next is please do ask me any questions. So there are some few couple of questions I have missed, I guess. So I'll just go up and try to tell you. Okay, so I think I have answered most of the questions that everybody asked. So rest now, we can talk on a few of the topics that there is about the pedo patients or the children. So the children are also, we have a particular specialist for the children that is called as a pedodontist. So what happens is children are the baby teeth. Most of them have this notion that the child has a baby tooth. So anyway, this baby tooth will go and a new teeth will come. So that is not the notion that we would like our viewers to follow. This is for your information that if you take care of your child's teeth from the time they are formed, it forms a better future teeth. So the time they have a certain cavity or there are problems which is occurring in a baby tooth, we definitely recommend you to bring them at the earliest. A child specialist will definitely come and diagnose the problem of the child. And there is, if it is a further of, you know, the child is forwardly placed, or if it is backwardly placed, or they have a particular habit. So all these things can be intervened. So there are, for different habits, we have habit appliances that are being given. Because the more you ignore a child's tooth, it will go into, you know, the permanent teeth that comes will also not be good. So a pedo or a child should definitely be brought in at the earliest. So again, I would like to tell you that this is a live chat show. It starts from 2 to 4 p.m. every day with one of our specialists. So I'm one of the resident doctors. My name is Dr. Tanuja. So you can just come and ask us any of your questions. So now next, what we can tell is we were discussing on the implants as well. So implants is again an advanced treatment for you if you have a missing teeth or you would look want to go for a permanent solution. So definitely implants is recommended these days. It is nothing but an inert material which is placed inside your bone, and once it's placed inside your bone, so this is one of the cases that we have done here. So here you can see that it is completely edentulous. There is no teeth. So there is no teeth there. So right after it is, the implants are placed. So the implants are placed. So once you walk into the clinic, we will definitely take an X-ray. We will see how much implants need to be placed in your oral cavity. and what are the how it will definitely improve the function, and it will improve your eating habits. So definitely implants are also the fixed way to go for. So implants is one of the most advanced treatments that we right now have in our clinic. And so next, any questions please do ask me. And slight spacing inside your teeth, for example, if there is a slight midline spacing, we call it midline spacing, where there are spacing between your teeth, where there is this slight spacing, we can definitely show you with a small restorative material. And and this restorative material can definitely be corrected. Or if it is to be recommended to, you know, for a permanent solution, you can always go for an orthodontic treatment. So the next question, the next thing that we can talk is how long should you, after placing an implant, this is the next question that has been come, if after placing an implant, are there any regular follow-up visits? Yes, there are definitely regular follow-up visits for after placing an implant. An implant, once it's placed or temporary counts are given, you can definitely come and we will be calling you up for follow-ups to see how the implant is being placed. Are you properly taking care of your oral cavity? And, you know, in the time of processes, you will have a healthy placement. So, and again, we have a toll-free numbers, 1-800-102-8686. Please call us for any of your dental questions or any of your appointments. You can also log into www.parthadental.com. We are a chain of clinics. The Partha Dental team is always here to serve you. And we were here today discussing on different diagnoses of different diseases and how your oral cavity is the mirror to your general health. A healthy oral cavity definitely will, you know, show that you're in good healthy condition. Certain signs and symptoms first occur in your oral cavity, rather than occurring in the rest of the part of the body. Like as we said, the bleeding gums, certain bone diseases are also there. So you can definitely come to us. We can diagnose your problem at the earliest stage, and that is one of the perks of coming here. So walking to any one of our clinics. So please do ask any questions that is there. About snoring and how to solve it. Do you have any treatment? Yes, this is the next question that has been coming up. So snoring, what we have something called as snoring silencer. It is an appliance. So snoring is nothing but is also called in a condition called as a sleep apnea. So there is an appliance known where the appliance will be placed. So this is the appliance for snoring that is being used. Okay, so it is called as a silencer. So what happens is that it will help to place the lower jaw and tongue are held in a particular position. So it will open up your airways. So once it opens up your airways, your snoring will reduce. So yes, Mr. Roy, we can have a solution for your snoring problems as well. So at a certain, because once it's a certain, at certain severity, the disease may cause certain sleepiness. You will not be able to sleep through the night. You may also cause disturbance to the person sleeping next to you. So definitely you can go for something called as a snoring appliance. It's called a silencer. So yes, we do have treatment for that as well. How is another question is, how is our hospital different from other hospitals? As I told you, we are much unique compared to other clinics. Is that our aim is mainly for the awareness, and we want to provide the best services. And other than that, as I told you, our treatment, the moment our hospital have treatments which starts as soon as you enter this clinic. You need not pay a single rupee. You can just start off your treatment on the same day itself with the blood scheme and the capital float that is readily available to you. in that particular day. You need not worry about the affordability. You just come into any one of our clinics, sit with any one of our specialists. All you need to worry is about your treatment plan, what is being told to you, and the rest, it is taken care of. So that is one of our unique qualities here. And also that if you walk into a clinic, we have all the modern facilities that are available. We have an intraoral camera, we have a digital camera, we have lasers available to you. So any modernized technology that you can see from, you know, which is there in Europe, UK, US, we have it right here. So that I can confidently tell you. So that is what makes us unique. And we follow a very strict sterilization protocol too. That is, we are in par with the European guidelines of protocol for sterilization. So definitely that is also something which is very important, because the treatments that you render to should be in a sterilization protocol. So we definitely follow those kind of protocols. We need not worry that, you know, once you enter, whether you will, you know, whether it is sterilized, whether it is not sterilized. I can assure you that we follow proper sterilization with the best equipment that is available. So that is how we are different from the other hospitals. So we have the three golden rules that we follow is accessibility to any one of our clinics that is readily available. And we have the availability of your doctors and the affordability. So that's the answer to your question. Which one is, next question is strong? Which one is strong, a natural teeth or implants? Okay, thank you for this question, Mr. Zakir. See, everything that is given naturally is definitely good, okay? But what can you do when you don't have it? So if you have a missing teeth, then the only option you can go for, we cannot replace your natural tooth again unless you go for something like a stem cell therapy or something which is more very advanced in this thing, which is right now not readily available everywhere. Other than that, natural tooth cannot be given once it's gone. So the next best thing to natural tooth is definitely implants. So yes, if natural tooth is better than the implants, no, because that natural is definitely natural. So I would suggest the next best thing would be for you to go for implants, because at least you'll have your teeth, you'll have a good smile. And as I said, a smile can straighten any curve. So having teeth will not only give you a good smile, it helps you to chew your food, it helps you in digestion, it will help you to, you know, have a good life. And in a good oral cavity and a good oral health, it definitely shows the mirror of a good general health as well. So that is all about the questions. And please do stay with us from 2 to 4. So we have our esteemed colleagues, my esteemed colleague will be joining you in tomorrow from 2 to 4 again. We are here on those who have tuned in just now, we are here for, we are in a web live chat where you can ask me any of your dental questions and any of the dental awareness. So anything that you want to know about particular treatments that are available, and anything that in particular you want to know about dentistry, about our clinics, please be feel free. Or for those who want to book an appointment, please call 1-800-102-8686. So as we go on to the next part of this thing, we have covered a lot of topics, which is diagnosing of diseases, as is dental caries, then your disordered arrangement of your tooth, and then we have what we covered was on your missing teeth, where we talked about the implants, where we talked about different modalities of how you can replace your missing tooth, and then we have come about your gum diseases, and also small simple things such as how you can enhance your smile. I've told you about the tooth jewelry. I've told you about bleaching processes. So another case is we can see when all should you go for a smile designing. Smile designing is particularly recommended for people who do not have the time to go for a fixed orthodontic treatment, or they are in need to have a smile for any professional, you know, any professional event or particular thing or a particular function that is coming lifting up. So a smile designing is definitely recommended. And another set of people that definitely I would recommend smile designing or placement of crowns will be those people who are suffering with amelogenesis imperfecta, which means that I'll show you a picture here, right here, where the tooth, once it's formed, it comes in a deformed and a discolored form. So these kind of things can also be corrected by crowns, the placement of crowns. The entire teeth can be redesigned, and crowns can definitely be placed. So all these things can be done in our clinic. Please, I recommend you once again, please walk into any one of our clinics, book an appointment with a specialist. We are here, we are a team of doctors who are ready to serve you. So please ask me any questions from 2 to 4 p.m. We are here, we are available to ask any questions. The next set of thing that we would like to discuss on is anything that is, please ask me any question here. So we were discussing earlier on the ulcerations and particular lesions that occur inside your oral cavity. So as I said that, should you be careful if should you be aware, or should if there is an ulcer in your cavity? Yes, sometimes ulcers do occur inside your oral cavity due to various reasons such as stress or your food habits. So if you suddenly eat something new, or it causes a sort of, if you're under chronic stress, it causes a lot of ulcers. Some people have it regularly, once in a month, or it can occur during any periodical process. But yes, when should you be concerned? More concerned of it is when it does not heal. See, for example, in this case, it's a non-healing ulcer, and so this is an ulcer that you can see right here. The ulcer is non-healing. So in this case, you can just see that when it is non-healing, definitely you need to be a little more concerned, because it can lead to a cancerous form too. So I would definitely recommend you to go and do a consultation with your nearest dentist. So anything else, please ask me any question. I'm here to answer any of your questions. So there are a lot of diseases which can occur in the oral cavity. Even the bone diseases, for that matter, can also occur as certain conditions inside. So there will be a loss of density of a bone. Suppose if you are calcium deficient. Also, calcium is now a major concern for all the women out there. What happens is that since all of you do avoid a lot of sun, so and vitamin D is not, the requirement of vitamin D dosage is not there. So what happens is this also affects your bone. What inside your oral cavity, the bone level does come down, and this can also be vitamin D deficient. Females are most common thing that we encounter in our day-to-day practice here. So again, a gum rejuvenation therapy, a bone therapy should be done for your vitamin D deficiency, where you will be put on a particular number of the vitamin D sachets. And once the vitamin D it comes to a normal level, together with your gum therapy as well, it will definitely cause a lot of improvements. So other than vitamin D. So as we talked about ulcers, we talked about caries, we talked about your wisdom tooth, we talked about different types of facial pains that can occur, which people are unaware of. So a facial pain and TMJ disorders, that is the temporomandibular joint disorders, for those who are chronic tobacco users, and these things can also be there, where lesions do occur inside the oral cavity. So people suddenly become all scared and think that it is cancer. No, let me just tell you that no, it's not cancer yet. It is just, you need to be diagnosed at an earlier stage. And once it's diagnosed at an earlier stage, it can be definitely be prevented, and it can definitely, be stopped at a particular point. So we will do a lot of dietary modifications for you. We will do a particular treatment plan for you and a proper follow-up. So you can just tune in with us, and we can definitely tell you what all to be done during such a treatment. process. So then the next, these are a few things that I can go for. As I told you, if you have a particular systemic problem that is available, that is there inside, you are a hypertensive, you are a diabetic, you are you know, suffering from any thyroid diseases, and these diseases can cause actually a lot of changes inside your oral cavity. So all these diseases will show certain signs and symptoms, and these symptoms can definitely be seen. So once it's seen, definitely you need to be diagnosed. So I would ask you to come in any one of our clinics, get diagnosed by our doctors. There is 84 plus branches, and there are a lot of doctors which are available, which will be on each and different level, each and every level, each specialty. There is a lot of doctors, so you need not worry about it. Please do come. So as I would like to tell you that this is one of our programs that we do conduct to share an awareness. We want to share an awareness. We want all the patients to be accessible to our clinics, and we want to tell you that it is affordable. So I would like to wind off this program right now. Thank you for joining in with me, and thank you for all your wonderful questions. So until the next time, this is Dr. Tanuja. And for those of you who want to continue, who want to know more about your dental awareness, or you have more questions, please tune in tomorrow with one of my colleagues again from 2 to 4. Thank you so much. Have a good day and keep smiling.